There's two more ways you can do vibrato, and one is horizontal vibrato. You've seen this with classical guitar players, like you know, violin players, and sometimes even guitar players. They kind of do this movement, like that. And now, technically, with the guitar, because it's already tuned, you cannot detune the string down, right? You can stretch it and raise the pitch, but it's impossible technically to make it lower. But when you do this, you're actually creating that effect. The reason is that you're pressing the note here and creating a tension against the fret. And I'm talking about millimeters, but then when you go backwards, the string actually becomes just a little bit shorter. I'm sorry, just a little bit longer, and then makes the note a little bit flatter. And it's almost imperceptible, but it's very sweet to the ear. And then when you go back again, you bring it back in tune. And so the technique is something like this. Now, because we're not actually exerting any force vertically, we're going to leave the thumb where it's supposed to go, which is behind the fretboard. And we do this. We play a note, and we vibrate like that. See that? Sounds really good. And this is as good a time as any to show you how you can do this in time. So you can get a metronome and get it to any speed you like. And you can do this with this vibrato or the vertical one, whatever you want. And decide, well, okay, I'm going to play one vibration per beat. So let's say your tempo is like 1, 2, 3, 4. So what you do is go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you practice that to keep your vibrato in time. When you're comfortable with it, you do twice in one beat. So it will go 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it's a bit faster, but it's still pertinent to whatever you're playing because it follows the right timing. Then we'll do triplets. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. And it will sound like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And then we can do 4 times per beat, like 16 notes, and it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this will allow you to always play in time, not only in tune, but in time too, which is always good. Okay, so this is horizontal vibrato. And now for the final part, we're gonna look at circular vibrato, which is kind of a mix of the two. What we do is we start in one position. You can do it in both directions. We could go up. Then as you release the string, you go towards the fret. Then you go down and back. And it sounds like that. It's pretty sweet. With distortion, it's a bit harder to control, but you get the sustain, which is kind of cool. And I like it to be a bit obvious like that. You know, I like that you can hear the pitch going in different directions. Some people are very smooth with it, and it's very good to listen to. And so you can practice both ways, a bit more aggressive or very, very light. Okay? Give it a try, and we'll go on now with the slides.